Hey guys, this is getting exciting. I finally got the ThunderSky batteries in. These are 45 60 amp hour cells. All these are going to go in the rear battery box. Let's get these old batteries out and we can see how we're going to arrange these ones. Looks like I'll be able to fit two rows of batteries, 14 across, and then to get the rest in, I think I'm going to have five banks of three, like that, and that'll get 15 more, and there's two left after that, which I think will just be single cells, one here, and there, one in that corner. These batteries, you can't just leave them sitting open like this, they have to be restrained so they can't expand, because when you charge them, they expand a little bit, and if you let them do that, the plates will separate and the capacity will be reduced. So for these ones, I'm just going to wedge some materials against the edge of the battery box. And that should be enough to stop these ones from expanding. But the other ones that are going in here won't fit so tightly, so I'll have to clamp them like they originally did when they shipped them. But all these are all, they were shipped clamped as groups of four, but those won't quite fit. You need to change all these, shorten all these clamp straps so I can strap them into groups of three. That's quite a big job because there'll be there's 40 of these straps to cut down and drill, so I need to make a relatively efficient operation to make this possible in a reasonable time. As you can see, there's a lot of straps here to drill, so the process I've come up with for doing this is just to make a little mark for where the bend has to be. Then, once those are all done, bring it over to the drill. I've got it set up to, you can position that and it will drill the hole exactly in the right place. This case, it's 11.5 millimeters farther than the mark. And I went through a couple of tries and figured that was the right amount so that when you clamp it in the vise with the mark right at the edge of the vise and bend it over, that'll put the hole in just the right position. And if you bent it first, it would be very difficult to drill, so that's why I'm drilling them first. Then you just cut the ends off and those bars are done. And there we go, just needs to be cut off now. And I have to do this 40 more times, or 39 more times. Somewhat tedious work, but these things are coming together. All these straps are going on. Three of them done already, so these should be ready soon. All the batteries are in the final positions now. I've got the top row wedged. Just use some old catalog paper. All the other ones are strapped. I think I'll wedge stuff in here to hold these in place that way. And in these little triangular corners, I think I'll line the bottom with plastic and fill it with expanding foam. That's probably the easiest way to wedge everything solidly in. I found that the battery box was about a millimeter or two out of true, that the bottom was wider than the top, so I had to make some feathered bits of paper changing thickness to take up that how it's non-true. This seems to be a pretty good way of doing it. Just cut pieces off as you go and it makes a nice wedge. I'm gonna have to make some more of these battery straps because they didn't send enough with the batteries. Batteries come as banks of four cells and they sent 11 of those, and each one of those had three of these straps on it. So I'm going to have to make eight more for this pack configuration at least, plus three other jumpers that are different sizes than those straps. Let's see how well this paper cutter works to cut the copper. Seems to work pretty well. Hey, it worked very well. see if it's true. Yep. Now I'll cut a bunch more of these and cut them into bits. I have to bend them somewhat like this for strain relief, then drill them. These are all drilled now. That was actually quite difficult. To stop them from jamming up, I had to hold them down with a piece of metal like this. If I didn't do that, when it gets through the last layer of copper, it tends to bind up and wreck the thing. It can also be quite dangerous if you're holding it because you have these sharp edges spinning all over the place. So definitely check to make sure you buy enough of these straps if you're ever buying batteries for a car like this. Anyway, let's get this heat shrink shrunk, and then we can start putting the BMS in. All the cell interconnects are done now. Made up a few special ones for different runs. This one has the current sensor on it for the BMS. That one has the fuse, a slightly longer one with a lot of strain relief. Anyway, this next time we'll install the BMS. So stay tuned for that video. Thanks for watching.